tail of the tape for our next contest. Ladies and gentlemen, we go back to heavyweight. This fight and the next one will be at heavyweight. And we have got some big, big boys about to throw down right now. Send it up to the cage and Grant Waterman.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest will be fought in the Bushido heavyweight division. Please welcome our first fighter making his way to the blue corner, Ibrahima Sene.
Everybody's grooving in the arena right now. Something about this song. He's got all the heads bobbing right now. Ibrahima Sene of France. 28 years old, 185 centimeters. Both these guys are actually a little bit short for heavyweights, but man, they are thick. Thick as a brick. Ibrahima Sene makes his debut here tonight, and we'll be taking on El Al-Saidi, who is slightly more experienced and slightly heavier, but I do think that this is going to be a very evenly contested matchup, but we will find out. When you got two guys this big stepping into the cage, anything is possible, and sometimes fights like this do not last very long, ladies and gentlemen, so be prepared for that. From what I've seen of Sene yesterday at the press conference and today, he seems very calm, very relaxed, very cool, and just wants to get in there and have some fun. Do his job.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our second fighter, making his way to the red corner, from France, Salim El Ousaidi.
El Ousaidi is 5 centimeters shorter, but is 8 kilograms heavier. I mean, this kid is really, really thick. And made his debut in May of 2021 and already has 3 professional fights under his belt. So he has been pretty busy considering that the time of his debut, we were still under a strict, you know, COVID-19 measures in a lot of places. Very hard to even find a fight at that time. So the fact that he was able to squeeze in 3 pro fights since May of last year tells me that he is motivated and he is hungry and he is ready to go. His first fight was a loss and then he won 2 straight. So he's on a little bit of a roll here and would like to keep that going.
Introducing these two Bushido warriors once again, fighting out of the blue corner. This fighter is 28 years of age. He stands 185 centimeters tall. He weighed in at 104.3 kilograms. He's making his MMA debut this evening from France. He is Ibrahima Sene. And fighting out of of the red corner. This fighter is 26 years of age. He stands 180 centimeters tall. He weighed in at 112.8 kilograms from France with a record of 2 wins and 1 loss, Salim El Ouassani! Your referee in charge of the action is Ahmed Kochi.
You saw him shaking his belly around like a bowl full of jelly. And he's proud of it. He's going to put all of that weight to good use. I guarantee he's going to put every kilo of weight behind those big shots that he's going to throw. Low kick going in off the bat there from El Ouassani. Whoa, and a very lightning quick low kick there in return from Sennett. Little left hand may have grazed the chin. I don't know if there was maybe an accidental eye poke or what there was, but Sennett apologized for it. But he fights his way in now, trying to get in close. And from what I've been informed, elbows are in fact legal, so there must have been some confusion with the rules there. So elbows legal in this MMA Bushido event. Got his man on the ground and he's just railing him with elbows, and El Ouassani is lucky there. He didn't get the fight stopped because the way he was holding his hand, it was almost like he was saying he gives up. Oh man, you can hear the crack of that kick echoing off every wall in the arena here in Brussels, Belgium. Fights his way in again, letting his hands go. And Sennett puts a stop to that now, trying to get his man off balance here against the cage. Good knee there. Boy, it's hard to get this guy down. He's got such a low center of gravity, but he does eventually get the big guy down to the canvas now from behind. Left hand's going in. Pulls that leg out. Right hand caught him. And he very blatantly used the cage there to get back up. Sennett has got to be weary of those back elbows of the Moroccan. Trying to get that left arm around his opponent, and he does. Oh, and he slams him right to the ground that time. The whole ring shook when he fell. Oh, right hand's going in. And you can see that Senna is certainly not in a hurry here to look for a choke or anything like that. He just wants to brutalize his opponent. That time, El Ouassani made his way up to his feet. No use of the cage necessary and brings a head kick up. Way off the mark there with that left hand. And I believe the referee warning about keeping those fingers extended. He almost got him earlier in the fight, and the referee warning him about it again now. Now he makes sure to have his fist clenched. Pops him with a left hand. Sticking and moving now around the ring. He's got that smile on his face once again. I think that's when Sennett is at his best, when he's calm and relaxed and in a good mood. And he popped him open that time, I think, with that shot. And the blood now pouring out of the corner of the right eye now. Boy, it is just drizzling all over his opponent. Take a look at the footmark on the back of the right thigh, too. He took a heck of a low kick earlier in the round. We're inside a minute now in round one. Oh, and there's that back elbow I was talking about. He uncorks that sucker, and watch out. You can see that Sennett keeping his head real tight to the back to avoid that. And he's going to try to bring that left arm around again, but not before he gets taken down. That's got to be at least two or three takedowns here in this round by Sennett. It's going to add up real nice for him on the scorecards here. If we get to the end of round one, took another shot in that eye. Grabs the leg out, brings him back down. Look at the smile, that sick little smile on the face of Al-Sidi. Gets back up again. Closing seconds here of round one. The blood now dripping into the eye. And that's it, end of round one. Well, he just tasted his blood and he likes it. Now, I spend a lot of time in Romania, and I know I've heard stories of vampires down there. Never heard of any stories of Moroccan vampires, but you never know. Some highlights here from round one. Ibrahima Sene of France. There you see a nice takedown by him on Salim El Ousaidi. That's got to be a round one in favor of Sene. He's had at least three takedowns, if I was correct. In that round. Not to mention he busted open the eye, so he's doing damage with his strikes. He has a significant mark. That's the low kick right there, the one that tagged him on the back of the leg right there. That round one, in my book, belongs very clearly to Sennett. Let's see what round number two brings. Round number two underway here. El Ousaidi looking for low kicks early. Eats a right hand from underneath. Oh, what a combo. The big guy finally getting something going here. But Sene putting the squeeze on. Staying nice and tight, making it hard to take any strikes. Look at he's digging his forehead right into his opponent. Gonna try to sweep the leg out like he did before in round number one. Ooh, brutal knee that time. Nice move there by the Moroccan. Gets a little separation now. And now it's his turn. No, Sene again turns him and puts him up against the fence, really jockeying for position. Now another great knee from the Frenchman. Looking for a takedown, tried to change levels there, but getting caught on the left arm there. See if he can finish this. He's working on that leg, but he's getting caught underneath with small little shots there from the Moroccan, and now he gets him again. Still a long way to go here in round number two. And Sene, he loves this position. This is now he's got to keep his fingers out of the cage. Sene still working for that takedown. Oh, a couple of shots being snuck in there by the Moroccan, and back up against the fence we go. Sene is just relentless with his game plan. He knows what he needs to do. He's got good striking when there's separation, and when there's not, he's always working for that takedown, and he's got it a number of times. So he seems to be outpointing El Ousaidi at every turn. Time. by Al-Sidi, and this crowd ooing and awing at that one. He got me too, and there's a nice takedown. Finally, Al-Sidi got a little something going in his favor here, and this could be bad news for Stennett. Because once you get a big guy like that on top of you, it's hard to get him off. Elbows now coming in. Big left hands now, really trying to measure his opponent. Those are getting through. Those are chiseling shots to the side of the jaw, right in the upper part of the jaw. That'll make it hard to chew. He may be drinking through a straw tomorrow. More shots going in now, this time to the opposite side of the head. And the referee getting a good look here. Stennett's got to move. He's got to move. And he's got to show signs that he's defending himself or at least improving his position. Or this thing's going to be called off. Like I said, when you get a big guy on top of you like that, it's hard to get him off. Oh, more shots going in. Referee warning him, and now he steps in and it's over. Great job by Al-Sidi. Never gave up, never gave in, never backed down. And his persistence paid off. Took a lot of damage in round number one, got taken down quite a few times, but was able to turn things around here in round number two and gets the stoppage by TKO. Let's take another look at how it went down, folks. Al-Sidi outweighs Stennett by 8 kilos, or at least he did yesterday. Who knows how much these guys weigh after breakfast and lunch. But I'm telling you, you get a huge individual like Al-Sidi on top of you, and it's not easy to get him off. He was just like a rabid animal there once he got on top of him. Look at those punches. Those are heavy, heavy shots going in there by the Moroccan, and that was just too much for Ibrahim Estene. Grant Waterman has entered the cage and will make it official here in just a moment.
Fighters to the center of the cage, please. Ladies and gentlemen, at 4 minutes, 37 seconds of the second round, we have a winner by way of referee stoppage to ground and pound and TKO from France, Salim Al-Sidi.
Well, the Buddha belly did it. I know he's not Buddhist, but that belly is good luck. He got the job done here. Boy, his neck is so big, they can barely get that thing around him. Congratulations to Al-Sidi, and we will be back with another heavyweight contest in just a moment. Stick around.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with your winner of our last contest, Salim Al-Sidi. Salim, this fight was not over in the early round. It looked like you were having problems, but then you turned it around in great fashion.
J'ai essayé de faire du mieux que je pouvais. Le stress, il me bouffe encore beaucoup d'énergie. Je fais encore des bêtises à cause du stress. Mais je réussis à renverser grâce à Dieu, alhamdoulilah, la tendance.
I did everything well. Sometimes I did some mistakes, but all okay, good.
But you love a war. What's next for you? Onward and upward?
C'est quoi le prochain pour toi?
Faut voir avec mon manager, le patron, c'est lui. Faut voir avec lui.
He's gonna check out with me, his manager.
Anything else to say for your fans here tonight?
Qu'est-ce que tu veux dire pour ton fan?
Ben, je tiens à remercier tout le monde qui est venu. Hein? J'ai été accueilli ici il y a un an et demi. J'ai beaucoup d'amis à Bruxelles. J'ai appris beaucoup des Bruxellois. Voilà. Je tiens à remercier Dani, SB, le patron, Ruskov, le gros lard, qui me combattra bientôt en Park Knuckle, le gros lard lol. Et je tenais à dédier cette victoire. On a perdu un frère cette semaine. Voilà, on l'a enterré jeudi. Que Dieu élargisse sa tombe et lui ouvre les portes du paradis, Inch'Allah. Dites Amin. Voilà, Najib, c'est pour toi, on t'embrasse. Voilà.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Salim El Ouessaidi.